Chapter of the notorious Outlaw Motorcycle Club is now calling Anderson home.
And the president says that he wants to be a part of the community, but police are not sure about that.
CBS 4's Courtney Crown talked with the club's leader tonight about it. Courtney?
Mm-hmm. Well, Tony Lupica, who is the president of the Anderson chapter of the Outlaws Motorcycle Club, told me the community should not be afraid of them. Lupica says, quote, "We'll embrace you, you embrace us."
New neighbors are setting up their home base in Anderson on Fairview Street, and they're shaking up this property.
Rape, pillage, and plunder. That's not what we're here for. It's just a gathering of like-minded people, and the community, I think, is going to come together for us, and they're going to see us just as guys who like to ride motorcycle and their friends.
Tony Lupica is the president of the Anderson chapter of the Outlaws Motorcycle Club. They just purchased this 3.8-acre area from another motorcycle club. Lupica says it's between their Fort Wayne and Indianapolis clubs.
You have to keep up with the times. They can't possibly do what they did in the 50s.
The Outlaw Motorcycle Club carries a reputation of past criminal activity. Court documents show in 2013, 51 people associated with the Outlaws in Indiana were charged for offenses like racketeering, drugs, and witness tampering.
Most presidents of chapters and most outlaws themselves know that it's detrimental to the club when something like that happens. And of course, we do our due diligence and say, hey man, don't do it. It's not worth it.
Lupica says his club is about brotherhood and biking, and eventually community involvement.
Any events that help the community out as far as biking goes, we'll attend. You know, we're just here to be part of the community and integrate.
Anderson police are hoping for the best. Officers say they are familiar with the outlaws' reputation.
Basically, we're just going to watch and wait and see how they conduct themselves. They say they're going to be good citizens and productive citizens in Anderson.
Well, there are specific ways a person becomes an outlaw. Lupica didn't lay out specifics other than it takes more than a year, and then they take a vote. Police, prison guards, women, and child predators are not accepted into the club. Debbie.
All right, Courtney.